They've been done in a much better.
Let's try our first one, shall we?
Yeah, first one.
What's this one?
This is truffle vodka.
The one you're not going to like, Tim, isn't it?
That sounds strong.
I don't like truffle.
Cheers. It's very subtle.
Cheers, Rebecca.
It's very subtle. It's made with Perigord truffles from France that macerate in the vodka for 2 weeks, and then it's triple filtered to get the little bits out.
Oh, it's nice.
It is nice, isn't it? And do you know what it's really good in? A dirty martini. Yeah. It's one of my favourite drinks.
Truffle oil that smacks you in the
nose.
Yeah, that's it.
But then that's often synthetic, and this is this is natural.
It's a little bit earthy. Aren't vodka's the hardest thing to sort of...
No, I wouldn't.
Aren't vodkas the sort of hard, like gins are all taste different, but the vodkas, don't they all taste pretty similar?
No, not so much anymore, again, because it depends on what they've been distilled from. There's one that's made from grapes, for example, which is very different tasting. And I had one this week that isn't on the market yet called Black Cow, which is made from milk. And that was completely different.
So okay, so vodka's a process, is it? Not an actual made of one thing in particular?
You can make it from anything with kind of carbohydrate starch in it, yeah. So some of it is potatoes, some of it's grain. You can make it from milk, as I discovered. Yeah, all sorts of things.
Would you drink this neat, though, or would you always use it as a combination?
You can certainly drink it neat. I think because it's so tasty, you can drink it neat, at about room temperature, which is at now.
How much is this?
This one is £42.
Whoa, quite like that.
This one, it's got £10 worth of Perigord truffles
in. Cheers.
Love, joy.
What has?
This has got £10 worth of Perigord truffles.
That was what we just dropped.
That smells nice.
Sorry, so this one is Damson vodka. This is by Sipsmith. This is macerated damsons for sort of 3 or 4 months.
Wow, I wasn't
expecting
that.
Tiny bit of sugar. It's not too sweet, is it? It's kind of really rich flavoured, but not...
Without being rude, it tastes medicine-y.
I think it tastes like Campari almost.
Yes, that's what I was thinking of. But is that because of the colour?
It's got a bit of almond note in it because it's whole fruits and the stones are in there. You get this kind of almondy-ness out of it.
You're right. It reminds me of something called Licor de Guindas, which is a black cherry spirit from near Sevilla. It's a very small production. It's really good. A bit sweeter than this, but... Very nice, I like that.
And what would you have this with?
So this you'd actually have neat, or you can drop a little bit of it into a glass of Prosecco or champagne.
How much is this one?
Really good. That is £23.
We've talked about food in front of house. How important is the drink in a restaurant?
Oh, I think it's really important, actually. More than ever at the moment, people really like a cocktail and they like a well-served drink. And so if you've got a restaurant and you want to get people to spend a bit more money, get some nice glassware and a barman who knows what he's doing and you'll get people to spend more.
Get a barman who knows what they're doing.
Yeah, definitely.
A bad cocktail's a terrible cocktail.
Well, definitely. And this is a great thing about these as well, is they're great ingredients for cocktails, so they kind of do some of the work for the bartender.
This smells lovely.
What's this one?
This is sacred spiced vodka. This is, I should say, actually, these are all British, and the last two are made in London. This is distilled very similarly to gin, but without any juniper. It's got 7 botanicals in it, including angelica and frankincense. So it's really deeply flavoured. This is great in a Vespa martini, actually.
Nice. Alcohol-wise, it's all about the same strength.
That's great for martinis.
This tastes stronger.
No, they're all about the same. We're about
this has got a real kind of wow.
How much is this one?
That is £29.
So you might have to break with your rules here, might you?
I do have to break with my rules. I usually pick the most expensive because I'd like. Try like to be a snob, but I think that is my favourite out of those three.
I'd go for this one.
This has got a lovely story behind it as well. It's made by a husband and wife team in their house, and it's kind of
legal.
They kind of do it in a sort of semi-scientific way, but also with lots of stuff they've invented themselves.
I was going to say semi-detached when you start with semi.
And some of their pumping equipment is in a Wendy house in their garden.
I want to go there. I've gone quite light-headed after that one. It's very good. I enjoyed that. So we all think that's our favourite.
Yeah.
Brilliant. Thank you very much, Rebecca.
You're welcome.
Yeah.
Good one. Now, when we come back, the Saturday...